It's a miracle, everyone. Lindsay has recovered from her tragic illness that befell her last episode. You know, totally not self-inflicted, totally wasn't a hangover. You know, she was definitely extremely ill and has made a miraculous recovery. I like how they didn't even mention it during this episode. Like, yeah, very clearly that Lindsay just had a hangover and was embarrassed by herself, got Mark to take her to the hospital. Absolutely ridiculous. This whole episode was Lindsay being ridiculous. Lindsay proving once again to all of us that she is in no way, shape, or form ready to be married or in a long-term relationship. And this whole, like, I don't even know. There are just so many ridiculous things this episode, starting with, you know, that miracle illness just magically disappearing and us just carrying on with life. So we open with some Lindsay selfie cam and she's ranting. We've seen these before. And she's talking about how Mark was saying that Lindsay is too loving and Lindsay is too kind and Lindsay is too caring. No, he didn't. He definitely did not. He said, "You're too much, Lindsay." That does not mean that you're too loving and too caring and too kind. That is how you interpreted that. That is not what all of us saw. When he says you're too much, it means that you are so over the top and such a roller coaster that he can't keep up. You know, if those clips did happen, we missed out because they were never shown to us. Lindsay thinks Mark should go find a lesser woman. Not even sure that's possible, Lindsay. I think you are the bottom of the barrel and you like to prove that to us each and every episode. Lindsay, like when they're meeting with Dr. Pepper, telling Dr. Pepper that she can't ever remember Mark telling her to stop. Like, of course, they're going to immediately cut to the clip of Mark repeatedly asking Lindsay to stop and her flat out ignoring him. Of course, they're going to start that. And like, Lindsay's doing this big drama production. And I think Dr. Pepper was buying it. You know, she's saying the wall's up and he's out. And like, all of a sudden, Mark has become the bad guy. Like what? How is that possible in that conversation? Like, we've seen Lindsay's behavior all season long. We know that she's the bad guy. And all of a sudden we've got this narrative that if Mark puts in more effort, everything can be fine. Like, I really thought that the experts were kept in the loop about what was happening with the couples, but apparently not. You know, maybe they sent all that information to the wrong house because we all found out this episode Dr. Pepper doesn't even live with her husband. Yeah, great choice of experts, everybody. I just can't handle that we just keep casting like unstable people on this show and try to pass it off as professional matchmaking and that this show's intention is for people to find love, because when someone like Lindsay gets cast, like, we knew before the season started that she was terrible. Like, there was no way around it. We all knew that she was terrible and was going to be terrible on the season. We didn't have to go through the casting process with her. We see one clip from her and it's like, yep, she's going to be awful all season long. Like, there is no accountability for the production crew, for the experts on this show, and it is absolutely absurd. I think the only thing I actually cared about this episode was Mark and JC. So, like, how can we have this moment where Mark is you know, making the decision to say goodbye to his cat that he's had for 14 years, and somehow Lindsay still manages a way to ruin it? I was I was absolutely, my skin was crawling. It drove me bananas watching Lindsay manhandle that cat while Mark was trying to just enjoy or share a final moment with JC. And there she is. She's just throwing that cat in a blanket, roughly just manhandling it, shoving the cat in the blanket in Mark's arms. Oh, it just drove me up the wall. Like, what? Like, how can she not read that moment that, you know, Mark is doing something that's very, very difficult for him, something that is hurting him very deeply. And she just comes in and she's got to fix it. She's got to do it Lindsay's way. It's just, you know what? It's too much. And I wanted to reach through that TV screen and just grab Lindsay and just completely remove her from that entire situation so that Mark could say goodbye to his cat on his terms. I just absolutely hated that moment. Let's talk about Lindsay's letter to her younger self. How is her letter to her younger self managed to work in a shot at Mark? How does that work out? People are going to think that you're too much. Like, how can she not even get through this one moment with, like, being real and authentic and genuinely committing to the letter? And, like, I feel like every other person on the show, you know, really dove pretty deep on their letters to themselves. But Lindsay, no, she just went and just picked off a couple of her favorite quotes off Pinterest and read them all off. You know, apparently she's achieved all of her wildest dreams. Lindsay, I guess you just didn't dream very big when you were little, because, you know, when I was a kid, I was dreaming of being an astronaut, going to the moon, playing in the NHL, being a famous rock star, famous actor. Like, those aren't even ridiculous dreams. Those are just the standard dreams that a kid has. You know, you see celebrities, you dream of being celebrities. And like, what was your wildest dreams growing up, Lindsay? You're like, yep, I wanted to be a completely unreasonable person. I wanted to just never be able to find a partner because I was so vile and unreasonable. You know, I wanted to just live a pretty average life in Boston. Wow. Those are some big dreams. Some big dreams Lindsay's out there having. You know, maybe she had just dreamed of being a terrible person when she grew up. And if that case, you know what, Lindsay, you're right. You did achieve all your wildest dreams. But we all wish you'd dreamed a little bigger. And then Mark, you know, Mark has his moment. And, you know, saying how, like, hey, he loved it. He loved it here. Had great memories here. And Lindsay just 100% set against Mark ever living in a place where he has good memories. You know, that's what I got out of that. You know, she was fine living in any other house, but not one where Mark had good memories. How dare Mark want to live somewhere where he felt a little bit of positive energy in his life? Can't wait for these two to get divorced on decision day. That decision day can't come soon enough. And I just hate how they're even pretending like there's a chance they could say yes on decision day. Like, why would you want to subject yourself to that, Mark? You know what, Mark? After this all ends and this show's done airing, you are going to have people who want to be in your life. And you know what? They're going to be a lot nicer to you than Lindsay is. You know, get through this, get to decision day, say no, and then check your DMs, because I'm sure that there are numerous women out there who would love to have you in their lives. So that's going to be it for Lindsay and Mark. Lindsay, we don't like you. We don't like you. We don't have to like you. And you've done nothing to make us want to like you. So that's going to be it for this week. As always, everybody, thank you so much for watching. And until next time, we will see you later.